The KP models usually used to study the properties of certain semiconductors. For direct band gap semiconductors, and in this case, we consider the following bands, and we consider the coupling between these bands within the KP approximation, assuming that this is small. So we consider the following structure. So we have the conduction band. Conduction band for direct band gap semiconductors usually has a symmetry, S symmetry of S orbitals. So it has some angular momentum zero and something like that, S symmetry, so it's isotropic. And then you have the valence band. The valence band has P symmetry. So it means that there are three valence band states, which has Px, Py, and Pz symmetry, angular momentum one. And initially there are three states, and they have the symmetry Px, Py, Pz. And usually following this Kp method, we assume that we know the properties of the state at k equals zero. So it means that at k equals zero we have four bands. And in this case, it's we also need to consider in many problems, we need to consider also spin orbit interaction. And this spin orbit interaction will introduce extra degree of freedom spin. So effectively it means that we have eight bands in this case, spin up, spin down, and four bands, and plus spin up, spin down, it will be eight bands. So the eight band model. The first model, which is based on the KP approach, is called the KN model. For KN model, we don't consider coupling with all other, with any other band. We consider only the coupling within this four bands plus spin to the eight bands, so it's a KN model. The parameters of the KN model is a band gap, this band gap, or another way we assume that this is zero, so it will be the energy of the conduction band, so it's a band gap. It's parameter of the KN model, and again in the KN model we consider only the coupling between these four bands. Then we need to introduce the, because in this expression you can see we have the matrix element of the momentum operator between these states. So it will be only the matrix element between S and P orbital states. So we consider matrix element of momentum operator between S state, and S state it will be zero because it has the same symmetry, and P operator has the same symmetry as X or Y or Z. Momentum operator between, for example, X state will be zero. X, it means that Px state, P, Y, Pz will be zero because again it has a P has the same symmetry as X, for example. If you consider, for example, Px orbital, P, X has the same symmetry as X, X symmetry will be X symmetry, and again X symmetry. So it means that it will be odd function of X, and when you calculate the matrix element or integral, it will be zero. Similar, the matrix element will be X, Px, Y. It will be zero because effectively this matrix element can be considered as the integral of the following type. It will be X symmetry, so it will be X. Px has the same symmetry as X, and Py has the symmetry of Y, and then it will be isotropic function. For example, it will be exponential Gaussian distribution or something like that. When you calculate the integral over Y, positive and negative, it will give zero expression. Similar for all other elements between X and Z and so on, Y and Z, it will be zero. The only non-zero matrix element will be between S, Px, and X orbital. Because now it has the correct symmetry. So this S symmetry is isotropic, it's L equals zero. Px has a symmetry of X, X has a symmetry of X. So effectively we have integral of X squared and then isotropic function. So it will be non-zero. Integral over X from minus infinity to infinity. So it means that in this case we need to introduce only three types of matrix element between S and X orbital, S and Y, and S and Z orbitals. And all of these matrix elements will be the same. So we introduce another parameter, which is called parameter P, which is a matrix element, for example, between S orbital, Px, and x orbital. And it is equal to s p y orbital in y and s p z orbital in z. So it will be exactly the same matrix element. So it's another parameter of the Keen model. So the first is a band gap, then it will be matrix element of momentum operator. And we have one more parameter, which is due to spin-orbit interaction. The effect of the spin-orbit interaction, because in this case it can be important and can be strong, is that for valence band we have px, py, pz orbitals. And these orbitals correspond to the angular momentum 1. When we introduce the spin, then angular momentum 1 plus spin 1 half, it will introduce angular momentum 3 half and 1 half. So it's a total angular momentum of the system. So this will be, the degeneracy of this state will be 2, and the degeneracy of this state will be 4. And spin-orbit interaction introduces the splitting between these two levels. If initially we have all the states are degenerate without spin-orbit interaction, spin up, spin down, x, y, and z, they have exactly the same properties, we have isotropic system. When we introduce spin-orbit interaction, it will split these two type of states. And this, the magnitude of the splitting is called the delta, let's call this delta. And this splitting determines this type of structure, so it will produce this structure. So at this point, we have the following dispersion, so it will be so-called heavy hole, light hole. They degenerate at this point at k equals 0, and then we have another band, which is spin-orbit splitting, so this energy difference will be delta. So it's another parameter of the Keen model. So finally we have three parameters which determine the Keen model, so it will be band gap, matrix element, and parameter delta, spin-orbit splitting. So this band is double degenerate, correspond to total angular momentum 1 half, and this point corresponds to total angular momentum 3 half. Of course, at this point they degenerate. When you introduce the finite k, it becomes non-degenerate, but still each band will be double degenerate. So roughly speaking, spin up, spin down, spin up, spin down. So effectively we have 1, 2, 3, 4 multiplied by 2 because of the spin, to the 8 bands in this approach. Then we need to write down the Hamiltonian, so we need to introduce the basis, corresponding basis, and the basis in this case at k equals 0, and write down the matrix corresponding to this basis. So k equals 0, so the set of the states will be s orbital spin up, then it will be x orbital spin up, y orbital spin up, z orbital spin up, so this corresponds to the valence band. Then it will be s orbital spin down, x orbital spin down, y orbital spin down, and z orbital spin down. So it will be 8 states. And then we need to write down the corresponding Hamiltonian in this basis of 8 states. So the Hamiltonian matrix will be takes the following form. So let's at first consider how do we write down this Hamiltonian matrix without spin-orbit interaction. So let's at this point disregard spin-orbit interaction. So let's assume that this delta is zero. So it means that initially all the states have the same energy, and then we'll just look at the effect of spin-orbit interaction. So initially we have the same energy, I'll just want to show the structure of the corresponding Hamiltonian. So in this case, we don't need to distinguish between spin up, spin down, so it will be exactly the same energy level. So we need to consider only 4 states. For spin down, it will be exactly the same wave functions and the energy level. So let's write down the corresponding matrix. So there will be 4 bands, and we need to write down this matrix in this 4 band approximation. So effectively, it will be 8 bands, but we don't need to consider the spin at this point. So to the matrix 4 by 4, and let's look at the structure of this matrix. So at first we look at the S state. S state, the matrix element, so H0, the energy of the S state will be delta G. So the energy is delta G, or EG, sorry. it will be EG. Then it will be diagonal element, so this part of the Hamiltonian, it will be just k squared divided by 2m, because this matrix element will be 0. So it will be k squared h squared, k squared divided by 2m. Then another, we can see the only diagonal matrix element at first. Then for state x spin up, again this energy h0, it will be 0 energy level, so we assume that this is 0. Then it will be diagonal element of k squared divided by 2m, it will be h squared, k squared divided by 2m. So this is for x orbital. For y orbital, it will be the same, h squared, k squared divided by 2m. And for z orbital, it will be the same, h squared, k squared divided by 2m. Diagonal elements. Then non diagonal elements. So this matrix element, Sx. So you need to consider only matrix element of this Kp term, so it will be only Px term will be non-zero, and Px matrix element will be P. So the Hm Kx P. So it will be H over M Kx P. Then matrix element Sy. So it will be the same only Kp term, it will be Hm Ky P. So it will be H over M Ky P. And similar S Z, so it will be the same Hm Kzp. It will be H over M Kzp. Then similar this one, it will be Xs, so it will be the same, so because this should be symmetric. H Kxp over M. Then this will be, let's put some, then this matrix element will be Xy, it will be 0. Because Kp term matrix element in xy is 0. Similar xz, Kp term will be 0. And similar yz, Kp term will be 0. So this matrix element will be 0. Similar, this is 0, this is 0, and this is 0. And this will be symmetric h over m kyp, h over m kzp. So this will be Hamiltonian matrix within the Kean model if spin orbit interaction is 0. So it will be only 4 by 4 matrix for spin up. For spin down it will be exactly the same matrix. And then you just need to find the eigenvalues of this Hamiltonian. And of course it will be the function of K, and we find the corresponding energy dispersion for the conduction and the valence band states. So they depend on K, and we can find the effective masses and so on. So this is the idea of this Kean model. Now when we have spin orbit interaction, so we change the structure of this Hamiltonian, and we need to introduce a little bit different bases in this case. So we introduce the bases to take into account that spin orbit, we have the spin orbit coupling. So the structure of the bases will be the following. So it will be S orbital spin up, then it will be X minus IY, so it will be PX orbital minus IPY spin up, then it will be Z orbital spin up and corresponding spin down. Then we have minus x minus iy orbital spin up. Then it will be similar orbitals with spin down. So it will be all the orbitals with spin down. So it will be s orbital with spin down. So it will be x minus iy spin down and minus x minus iy spin down and z spin down. So this will be the structure. So the reason why we introduce this combination of px, py to take into account the spin orbit coupling. As a result, if you introduce with this basis, then the Hamiltonian matrix takes the block structure So we have conduction band, then it will be to the generate valence band, and then from the spin split bend, so this will be delta, this will be